Hey, and welcome to Drive Time. I'm the Vernon Howe. I'd like to talk about ants this morning. It is a Thursday morning. It's chillier than it has been the last few days. It's the Thursday. It's March the 14th, 8:51 a.m. Eastern Standard. I would say it's in the 30s. Chilly. It was cold walking my dog this morning. Obviously still doing the cold thing. Got the cold going on, if you can hear my voice. The mornings are the worst. I wake up kind of in a NyQuil stupor, I think. I don't know. Those NyQuil, I'm just taking the normal dose, the full one cup that they give you with the NyQuil. I've been going to bed like 12:30-ish. So I've been doing that and sleeping for roughly my 6 hours. You know, my regular routine, but I've been waking up just way out of it, and just that's, I think, part of the cold, and looking forward to just getting some more rest. But I'm not going to waste your time with the cold. I want to talk about killing ants. I think I'm going to go to Rite Aid and try. I looked up a solution where if you mix sugar with boric acid. Yeah. Have you seen this? Have you heard about this? I don't know if it works. I think you mix in like a water solution, one part boric acid, I guess it's like a white powder. And you can buy it over the counter at drugstores, I guess. I don't know where in the drugstore it'd be. I don't want to spend too much time in Rite Aid looking around. And I hate talking to any Rite Aid employees. Nothing against the Rite Aid employees. I just don't want to bother them. It's a shitty job, and I don't want to have to make it any worse. That's not because I don't. They're all good. You know, nothing personal. I'm actually helping them by trying out, but I don't want to spend an hour looking for boric acid in the Rite Aid store either. Anyway, so I think if you mix these, I don't know if I can put it in a plate. They're basically, the ants are no longer in the kitchen. The ant traps work for shit, first of all. I should write whoever the company is that we bought those ant traps from, because they don't, we have like six of them in the bathroom, and we still have the exact amount of ants every day. There's always like one crawling on the sink and like two in the tub, like one on the ceiling. And that's like a minimum. So there's like, give or take, an ant or three. That's the ant population. At any given time you walk into the bathroom, it's not like an infestation of 100. They're the little tiny black ants. And they're not clustering. They're just kind of sporadically here and there. And like, we've cut down on the population of the ants. We haven't been able to fully eradicate them yet. And I don't like killing any creature. Part of me, you know, feels bad. I'm a little bit OCD with things like that. I feel like I can't meditate in the bathtub naked, sitting down, because the ants are lingering and there might be one crawling on me. I don't like to feel that. I haven't meditated in the last few days because of that. It's not good. I think that was doing me well. That naked meditation in the shower with my whale and fire sounds. Just trying to get. Just trying to get on track. It's just the work and that. You know, I gotta tonight. I'm not turning on my TV once. I'm not looking at it. I'm not even going to go in there. I'm going to spend my time tonight in my office. I've been setting up work the last 3 days in my living room, partly because I wanted to watch Tuesday and last night, because I wanted to watch the Big East tournament. And I'm not eating dinner till 9:30 these day nights. I've talked about this, but you know, I was watching Rutgers in the Big East tournament, and they fell to Notre Dame last night. A gutsy effort, though. They were plucky. They kept battling to the end. They kept cutting it to like six in the second half. It just could not get closer. If you're a sports fan, you happen to watch that. I was pulling for them hard. I have a problem with rooting for Rutgers sports. I got into it. You know, I'm not going to say I've been a lifelong fan of Rutgers Athletics, because that'd be a lie. But they are my alma mater, and I didn't until recently, really, towards the end of my experience there, get into them. When the football team started to get good, I started to get into both them and the men's basketball. And I will tell you that when I've rooted for, in the past, teams that have been successful for the most part, but this is a different kind of thing, because the ceiling doesn't seem like they could ever get, like, even just to get even remotely close to some sort of championship in either of those two main sports, for, you know, football and basketball, for a team like Rutgers, seems impossible. Like, it just doesn't seem at all fathomable. And yet, that's what you try and root for. You try and root for you take it, the macro and the micro. Each game is a thing to watch, and you root for them to win that game, and then that's it, and that's the one, that's your how you spend that time. But then on the grander scale, really why you watch sports is you want them to, you know, have that chance to be the, you know, to feel that, whatever the, however TV decides to package that moment. It's very important how directors and producers of sports television capture that moment. I remember when the Giants won the Super Bowl 42, I was unhappy with, I think it was Fox, how they covered the post game and those moments right after the win. It left me feeling kind of weird and empty inside. This is a good point to explore, and it's probably better off on my sports blog, sportsblog.blogspot. I don't even know. I gotta start updating that. I gotta play some sports bets tonight, but then not watch any sports. There's a guy on Twitter I follow who gives out free tips. He's usually pretty good. I think it's like, it feels like he always wins. And the migrant workers landscape away.